Namaskaram for all of you who are at the Medscape National Award Conference. I'm very sorry I'm not able to be there personally due to extreme overwork that's happening here. As many projects are on ground, I'm not able to make this trip this time. But I'm very much with you in this effort to save the girl child and woman empowerment. No civilization can call itself a civilization if the women in that society are not doing well. Well, in a nation where we have worshipped the feminine and continue to worship the feminine, unfortunately, in the last few hundred years, due to poverty, invasions and various other disturbances to the cultural dimension of what this nation was, one segment of the society which took the beating is the girl child and the woman. So a time has come to empower. Empowerment does not mean that dole should be given out. What I see is in most universities where I go and speak, well, women or young women or girls are in a proportion of very easily 50-52% in most institutions. But in higher education, if you look at various institutions where the number of women who are doing PhDs, I found engineering PhDs, the number of women are more than men. So this is empowerment. We just have to continue this process and just wait for maybe 5-10 years' time when naturally women will occupy various positions in the society, and this is how it should happen, not by protests, not by shouting slogans on the street. That is not the way. That will only set up two genders of the same species, one against each other. It's very important to understand what needs to happen is upliftment of humanity. It is very important if women have to live with dignity in a given society, sufficient work has to be done on men about their own evolution, their own civilization. It's very important. So, to uplift the woman, it's very important we uplift the whole humanity. So, this is very wonderful that you are doing this conference, keeping this as a subject. Because today in our nation, we are at a time when the entire population needs to participate. We cannot leave half the population behind and try to go ahead. Such a nation will not go ahead. So it's very important if we want full participation of the population, women are engaged in every activity that they wish to engage in. In terms of possibilities, in terms of opportunities, if you create a level playing field, then rest will be taken care of. I think that is happening in a very rapid way. Still in rural societies there are issues, but largely in educational institutions you see this level playing field is definitely happening, because where there is no physical prowess required, in those places women will naturally flourish, and that is happening in this country, that's happening in the world. Well, certain very regressive social practices are there, but we should not rake up those things too much. In terms of our constitution, there is equality. In terms of laws, there is equality. In terms of opportunity, there must be absolute equality. Once this happens, these regressive practices will naturally evaporate. It is best they evaporate. Don't try to scrape it off a society, because that will leave wounds. It is best that they must just evaporate. That will only happen by empowering the woman with education and equal opportunity. Thank you very much. I heard that you are all giving me an award. It's very embarrassing for me to receive any award, but thank you very, very much for even considering me as a part of this. And in whichever way we can support you and serve this cause of saving the girl child and empowering women, we are very much a part of this. Thank you very much. My best wishes and blessings to all of you.